Danielle. I am 59 years old. I was born and raised in Minneapolis, Minnesota, in a fantastic family. I now live in Phoenix, Arizona with my son and his wife and my grandchild, who is an incredible joy. I am disabled. I am on disability and have been since 2009. In 2004, I was in a terrible car accident. I was hit by a drunk driver. He was doing, they think, between 70 and 80 when he rear-ended me in a 35 mile an hour zone, and he never hit his brakes. A few neurosurgeries and a lot of medical issues. Later in 2009, I had to leave a phenomenal career that I loved. It was devastating to have to leave my career. I flew all over the United States, opening new restaurants, training management, all levels of management. I love teaching people how to operate a successful restaurant and make money. It's not easy to do, but if you know what you're doing, you can. Anyway, I was forced to leave my career behind. I don't allow that accident to define me anymore. I learned from it, and that's the best you can ask for in life, is to learn from every experience you're in. And frankly, every single person has a story. Everybody has something they've had to overcome, and it's all about how you overcome it and move forward, isn't it? So let's fast forward. Here we are. It's August-ish of 2022. I kind of get urged by a friend to dip my toe in the stock market. You know, you're a smart girl. You could do this. You can learn. You know, maybe take the little bit you have left and try and make it something more. Because the truth is, not having worked since 2009, I will subsist on Social Security when that day comes, and that will be next to nothing because there's no work history there for 14 years. I thought if I could, you know, learn what I needed to know, take the little bit I had and see what I could do with it between now and then, you know, why not? Let's give it a try. So August 2022, I start, I know absolutely nothing. I join some Discord groups. I'm watching videos. I am reading everything I can get my hands on. I am trying to learn as quickly as I can. And I open an account with TD Ameritrade, first time ever. I did have a Roth and a 401k. I don't have those any longer. So I'm going to take the little bit I have left, try and learn, and invest. When I hear the first peep about MMTLP, and I think, you know, well, what's that? What's a short squeeze? They're talking about a short squeeze. They're talking about a short squeeze of the century, a life-altering short squeeze. And I'm thinking, well, I need life-altering. Let's go. I do my homework on the company. I research metamaterials. I've researched as much as I can about NextBridge Hydrocarbons, the spinoff company. I've started a position where I buy some shares of MMTLP, and from August, I am adding to my position over time, right? And that brings us to let's get to December 9th. Okay, because that's a defining moment. I go to bed on the 8th, and thinking, you know, the price that had been at $12 some for just a second, and I thought, oh yes, it's on its way. But I thought, with only 2 days left to trade, I thought the price would be higher. But what do I know? Because I know nothing. This is the first short squeeze I play, I'm in. So I go to bed giddy because I'm thinking, oh my God, 2 days left. These shorts have to cover. I can't wait. I wake up on the 9th. It's not trading. So I call TD Ameritrade. What's happening? What's going on? Well, we got issued a halt by FINRA. Well, what is that? What does it mean? I'm asking a million questions. They're giving me goose egg answers. Nothing. So I try and start reaching out to different social media sites to gain some understanding. I listened to Ali on Trading Secrets. He's an incredibly intelligent man. And somehow I find my way to Twitter, where I find a community of people who are my guys, man. They also hold a position in MMTLP. They are like me, now sitting on nothing, because when I say TD Ameritrade did nothing, that's not exactly accurate, because they did at some point manage to take thousands of dollars in value that my shares held and make it a zero. So currently in my TD Ameritrade account, I hold X amount shares of a CUSIP, so nothing really. And it's worth zero. It has a $0 value, and I do not have shares of NextBridge Hydrocarbons. That was promised by our SEC and FINRA. You will, if you hold past this certain date, get 1-for-1 shares of NextBridge Hydrocarbons. It's been over 100 days. I do not have shares of NextBridge Hydrocarbons. I have called every senator and representative I can. I've called FINRA. I've called the SEC. I've called AST. I've called the DTC. I've written and called everyone I know of. In fact, I wrote our White House and they wrote me back. I am sad to say that it was one paragraph, and this is what it said. Thank you for alerting us to your situation with MMTLP. We will forward this to the appropriate financial agency. Who would that be? I'd like to know, because I would like to have a conversation with them about what is happening. What is my government doing to help me? Because frankly, they bailed out SVB Bank within 48 hours. I've been in this for over 100 days, crying to everybody who will listen, shouting from the rooftops, as have a lot, 65,000 investors and more are trapped just like me. I'm not the only one. I hope if you're watching, you're thinking to yourself right now, well, I hope what you're not thinking is this doesn't pertain to me, because it absolutely does. This was caused by short selling, naked short selling, illegal short selling, which our government, the SEC and FINRA, are supposed to be making sure market manipulation doesn't happen, and they are to be protecting retail investors. That's what they say on their websites. That's what they tell the world. That is not a fact. That is not a fact. They are not protecting me. They caused me harm, and they are unwilling to fix this. My government is unwilling to fix this. I have condemned other countries for the corruption that they are, that has gobbled them up, and it has happened to the United States, and it makes me sick. So get involved. If you're the government, do something.